And I agree. Mr. Marwah will be in a better position to answer this.
You did a commendable job. I'm not questioning that at all.
I'm neither defending myself nor.
No, no, one second. He's asking you a different question, Mr. Pereira.
I can tell you the amount of action done by North
District. No, no, no. Mr. Pereira, take his question. Repeat your question, the last part of your question. I don't think Mr. Pereira heard it. Mr. Gujral, please repeat your question.
I am saying, is it a fact or not that the police force under him was paralyzed? I am not blaming Mr. Pereira at all.
Yeah.
But the guys, the beat constables, the guys who were on the street, they refused to act. Did they fire a shot at the protesters?
Well, I can tell you, I did fire. I ordered firing, and we did, take action. And
there were so many other places in.
No, he's asking about your subordinates, Mr. Pereira. He's asking you a question about whether the police force was paralyzed because of political influences, Mr. Pereira. You are understanding the question, but you're not answering it.
No, to the best of my knowledge, wherever things came to my knowledge, I have seen to it that my subordinates acted.
No,
my
Mr.
subordinates
Pereira.
In the officers in Kingsway Camp, Azadpur, the officers in Andamogal and Sabji Mandi, they opened fire. Chaudhary Ragbir Singh, Kashyap was in Kingsway Camp.
Mr. Pereira,
all these opened fire.
Mr. Pereira, your certificate to the police does not match either what the Nanavati Commission said. Does not match what the CBI prosecutor said, and I would now like to bring in Mr. Fulka on this, because as far as I'm concerned, the CBI prosecutor very clearly said this was a case where the police acted in a pre-planned manner, where every policeman was keeping his eyes closed to the widespread violence. Mr. Fulka has more information on that. Accept the harsh reality tonight.
Mr. Marwah would be in a better position to answer this.
Accept the harsh reality on this, Mr. Pereira. Mr. Fulka will give you the details. Yes, Mr. Fulka.
First of all, let me say Mr. Maxwell Pereira was the only officer who opened fire and was able to disperse the crowd. If Mr. Maxwell Pereira can disperse the crowd by just opening fire once, then why couldn't the others do?
Yes.
That shows that the crowd was not so committed.
Absolutely.
If the crowd had been so committed, even if he had opened fire once, they would have gone.
Exactly.
Nobody came closer. That shows the crowds were not committed. It could have been easily dispersed. Now, number one.
Yeah.
Number two, page 45 of this judgment of yesterday, the court records the contention of the prosecutor of the CBI. The CBI says that the Jagdish Kaur recorded a statement on 3rd November 1984 and that statement has been removed from the records by the police. Now this is what the CBI investigation shows, and it is the CBI further says that these accused committed these killings in connivance with the Delhi police officials. So Delhi police is virtually a co-accused in this matter. Unfortunately, while dealing with Sajjan Kumar, the judge did not consider this aspect at all. Now the court says, like what Mr. Gujral also said, Manjeet Singh also said, when you go to the court, now till 2005 the investigation was with the Delhi police. Delhi police does not want to record any statement against Sajjan Kumar.
Why?
And it is only after the investigation goes to CBI the statements against Sajjan Kumar is recorded. Now the court gives him the benefit of doubt that
what does that tell us?
Are not recorded.
No, what does that tell us?
The
police has been scared. And I'm asking here today, what is the police scared
of? Not only scared, the police has been party to these killings.
And I'm asking here today, Mr. Maxwell Pereira, I'm not, you're not the only person to be answering here. But the fact is this, that there was a Poti Rosha committee appointed in March 1990. The committee issued recommendations for filing cases based on affidavits of victims who had suffered from violence. There was one against Sajjan Kumar. CBI team, am I correct, Mr. Fulka? CBI team went to Sajjan Kumar's house to file the charges. His supporters locked up the CBI team and said, "We will beat you up. We will thrash you if you continue to file cases against." And as a result of this intimidation, the term expired and the inquiry was disbanded. Is that a fact or not, Mr. Fulka?
No, just a minute. The CBI team went to arrest Sajjan Kumar. They arrested Sajjan Kumar. The CBI jeep was burnt by the
That's the point.
The people over there. police did not help them. And one more fact, Arnav, at 7 o'clock the CBI arrest Sajjan Kumar. At 10 o'clock the Delhi High Court grants him anticipatory bail.
Shocking.
Now this is one of our major grievances.
It's completely shocking.
7 o'clock he's arrested. 10 o'clock Delhi High Court grants him anticipatory bail and say, tell the registrar, you call up the CBI team.
So Mr. Marwa,
house to release him.
So Mr. Marwa, what? So Mr. Marwa, the only thing that I can summarize is that when you tried to do an honest job, you were stopped. Every investigation after you was stopped, roadblocks were put, and a number of pliant police officers fell in line and did nothing to their political masters as part of this cover-up, Mr. Marwa. Would I be right in making...
You're absolutely...
Mr. Marwa.
You're absolutely right in your conclusion. I can't comment specifically on any case because my inquiry was not completed. But two, three facts emerged from the whole situation. Number one, that the riots which took place and the maximum killing that took place were in areas which were not prone to riots. And the mobs which indulge in murder and arson and things like that were very small crowd, 15-20. And they dare not do this sort of thing unless they believe they will get away. Number two, it has taken 29 years for this judicial process and investigative process to go. Unthinkable. And thirdly, that the response of different districts was different. Maxwell is absolutely right. The North District did a much better job, and Chandni Chowk area, which is prone to riots, nothing happened. The Central District, which again is Karol Bagh and other areas which are prone to this sort of problem, were relatively quiet. It happened in areas like Palam and in the West District.
So, Mr. Marwa, you were police commissioner between 85 and 88. Can I ask you ever after that? And you don't need to name the politicians, but I want you to share a little bit more. Did you share your frustration? You've been governor also. Have you shared your frustration straight up with Congress leaders who could have made a difference, or any other political leaders?
You know, my inquiry was followed by inquiry by a sitting Supreme Court judge, Mr. Ranganath Mishra, who later became a Congress MP. But besides that point, now...
His report, with the greatest of respect, his report was a sham, because he said that it was not part of his terms of reference to identify any person and recommended the formation of three committees. So the Ranganath Mishra Commission had no use.
This is the point.
Yes, Mr. Gujral.
Arnab, anybody who gave a wishy-washy report was rewarded. A former Supreme Court Chief Justice is made a Congress Member of Parliament, and thereafter he's made a governor. What does it prove? Because he gave a wishy-washy report.
I want to ask you, Mr. Marwa, I am told that your report was taken over by the government and were later transferred to this Mishra Commission. However, the most important part of your record, namely your handwritten notes, which contained important information, were not transferred to the Mishra Commission. I want to ask you, Ved Marwa, where are your handwritten notes? Where is that information?
You know, first of all, there was no report written because I had not completed the inquiry. So the question of handing over the report to anyone didn't arise. Secondly, all the record which I had collected was handed over to Ranganath Mishra Commission as ordered by the Commissioner of Police and the government. Handwritten notes, I don't recall I had written anything handwritten.
Mr. Marwa, it is my instinct to know what happened to the explosive material. You are obviously sitting on explosive findings which you had found out about the complicity of the police, and this country would want to have access to your findings. Where are those findings now?
My explosive finding were those documentary evidence, the records of the Central Police Control Room and the records of the police station.
So where is all that material?
Which was handed over to the which was handed over to the commission. The my handwritten notes, if I had recorded, I don't
remember. But do you
that.
Think that should that be made public? Do you think your whatever you found out at that point of time, in the interest of, you know, transparency, should now be made public?
None of this record was in my personal custody. I had a deputy commissioner of police to assist me, and he was a very, very bright young officer who kept all the records and handed it over to the Mishra
Commission. I think it should be opened up. It should be made public. Absolutely. Last word to Manjeet Singh, please.
Yeah, why not? Why not? Why not?
Yeah, Arnab, I am of the opinion that this should be made public.
It should be made public.
One thing more I need to tell you here. Mr. Fulka said that a statement of Jagdish Kaur was removed by Delhi police, the CBI is saying. The thing is, there are cases where the main witness was called not once, not twice, 10 times their statements were taken. And later on in the court, even if I am to give a statement 10 times, somewhere or the other, the commas or full stop will shift. Something will change the meaning of the thing. And police played in the hands of the culprits, and they said that they always keep on changing their statements.
Yeah.
So they are not good enough to be believed. Secondly, today on your channel in the afternoon, I was watching, the Chief Minister of Delhi, Shrimati Sheila Dixit, said that why are they protesting?
Yeah.
If they have a problem, they should go to the higher court. Now tell me, I need to ask Madam Sheila Dixit that the investigating agencies had never caught anything recorded, had never collected any evidence.
True.
What will we take to the higher court? Madam Sheila Dixit knows very well that if we go to any court, this evidence is not going to book anybody. So there is a need to make an SIT for these riots on the basis of Gujarat riots. Only then we can get justice.
I think that there is one. Mr. Gujral, before I come to you, I want to go back. The truth is lying there somewhere in a government file. I put the question to all our viewers on NewsHour tonight. Here is a man who has been hounded and persecuted, Mr. Ved Marwa, for pushing the truth. And I know I'm extremely critical of Maxwell Pereira on most occasions, but I must commend him tonight publicly. He was one of the few police officers who took a gun and dared to fire at the protesters at that point of time, when other police officers didn't do so. But I think, Mr. Gujral, it is in the national interest that the Ved Marwa findings, instead of being put in some locker or cupboard somewhere, should be made public now. Because they have been concealed. They have been concealed for 29 years, Mr. Gujral.
Arnab,
I think the Ved Marwa's
Arnab,
findings, whatever
Arnab,
they are, should be made
be
public
possible
now.
If all this will be possible if the Supreme Court sua moto intervenes, as they did in the case of Gujarat.
Ah.
And the last thing I want to say, just before I came on your show, a Sikh gentleman called me from Hyderabad, and he said, our community suffered. It was state-sponsored terrorism in 84, and he said, I hope this time we are not made victims of judicial terrorism.
Well, I think, you know, people have such strong sentiments, they have reasons to do so. Mr. Marwa, I want to ask you this, because I know I'm getting, you know, persuasive on this point. I believe you were on to something somewhere. And because you were on to something somewhere, Mr. Marwa, there was an attempt to make you stop doing your job.
No, it is quite obvious. It is that the Delhi police, some officers of the Delhi police would have had a lot to answer. And when they had a lot to answer, somebody would ask them, why didn't you do it? And then the whole trail will lead to powers that didn't want to be exposed. Now, who those powers are, I didn't inquire, and I don't want to comment on that.
But you wouldn't have any problems with your report being made public?
No, there is no report. All the documents
your findings
being made public, which I collected, there were no findings. I didn't reach the final conclusion, because I still had to examine some important witnesses like the commissioner, the lieutenant governor, and some other senior people. So to get their reaction to what had happened. But the documents which I had collected, and I had collected a huge record, which, as I said, the deputy commissioner who was assisting me dutifully with receipt and all handed it over to Justice Ranganath Mishra. If they are made public, I think certainly it would help in everyone drawing its own conclusion that where things had gone wrong and where things had gone right.
Well, I think they should be. Mr. Marwai, thank you. Mr. Manjeet Singh, thank you. Maxwell Pereira, thank you very much. I wish there were more officers with your courage in 1984, Mr. Pereira. And my question to all the NewsHour viewers is simply this. Do you think whatever findings, whatever was the trail of investigation that Ved Marwai was following, should now be made public?